On Friday's trading session was Stride Shasun, which was in focus as the company, along with its Q3 numbers, announced restructuring of its non-core businesses. We're now joined by Arun Kumar, the Executive Vice Chairman and the Managing Director of Stride Shasun, to discuss exactly that and a lot more. Mr. Kumar, hi, thank you very much for joining in. First, wanted to talk about all of the restructuring that the company is undertaking in the next couple of months. One, your API business, which is going to be demerged. Secondly, you also have your low-margin Africa business, which you've, you're planning to sell, plus you're exiting your probiotics business in India as well. Overall, how much do you think your margins could possibly improve going into FY18 on account of all of this restructuring?
Hi, morning, Esther. Thank you for having us today. Before I get into specifics, you probably appreciate that in the last 2 to 3 years, we've been busy conducting several transactions, both organic and inorganic, to rebuild Stride's post our divestment of our injectables business to Mylan. The idea, obviously, is for the core business to get a sharper focus, to take away all the low-margin, high-capex, long-gestation business away, so that the remaining core business or the headline core business will be a high cash generating business with strong pipeline and R&D. So the core business has been established. We believe that we have achieved all the building blocks in the main business, which will be renamed Strides. And that's all about a B2C business, fully integrated, including API manufacturing, which we will not sell to third parties. And having reached now an R&D momentum of close to about 20 to 25 filings per year, which I think will get us into the fast track of growth in the regulated markets that we operate, predominantly US and Australia. We have already communicated to investors and to shareholders our idea of demerging the commodity API business. We don't see a strategic fit while building a B2C business to stay focused in also in the B2B business. So we thought that it's best in the best interest of shareholders to consolidate the API commodity business into a standalone company. Shareholders would get equity in that company. We are proposing to combine the scheme to include the API business of Sequent, which, as you know, is another promoter company, so that all interests are combined into one single company and we can build the API business into a very solid business in the near term. We believe there's a need for an organized API company, and I think our newly carved out business will give us that opportunity. Obviously, by simply restructuring, and coming back to your question, restructuring all of these low margin, high capex businesses, the core business margins would improve. Margin expansions have already commenced. As you can see in our last quarter, we expanded margins by about 300 basis points. So we think we will continue building from that strong foundation. And obviously, debt restructuring also, along with the restructuring, the debt recast will also happen, which means that the core business will generate significant cash and a high return on capital. So that's the whole take on the whole restructuring. The probiotics was a suboptimal business. It had only sales of less than 8 crores, so I don't even think we should speak too much about it. It's a very low end, it's an OTC business which didn't fit into the RX strategy. Probably one of the few deals that didn't go well. But considering that this is a 10 crore acquisition, I think it's not so material. One other key element, obviously, is the carving out of the biotech division, which you didn't talk about, but that is also a long capital, high gestation business. So we've now carved out that business after having considered several options. This allows Stride to focus on a pure B2C business with a good run rate and solid foundations for the future growth.
Mr. Kumar, good morning. Sir Prashant also joining in. Was a sale of the API business considered at some point?
No, we did not consider the sale of an API business. We think it is currently the commodity API business of the merged entity with Shasun is currently still a suboptimal single-digit EBITDA business. We have normalized operations by reducing outputs and getting a lot of price discipline. But we are a long way away before we can really get value. We think it's best to stay listed And that will give better valuation in the next 2 to 3 years to shareholders.
Okay. You have done a lot of acquisitions in the past few years and months. Is your focus now going to be on integrating them, or can we expect an acquisition from the likes of Strides on Inova, an Australian company which is spoken about a lot right now?
No, so I think we've been very focused on integrating the transactions that we acquired, and we announced it in our last, not in this quarter, in our last quarter results, that we've now completed very successfully all our integrations successfully, and some of these actions that we have done in restructuring only reflects a sharper focus to what we have already integrated. Strides will continue to look at growth opportunities. We have a much stronger balance sheet today. We will be obviously very conscious about what assets we will chase and what markets that we will operate. Currently, the subject of Inova that you're bringing up is only in the public domain. There is a process that's ongoing, which is known to the industry. But at this stage, it's very, very early days for us to even make any comments on our strategies around this asset. I mean, we would look at this asset as any other opportunity in the territories or the markets that we want to specialize.
Right. Now, to shift focus to what's happening in the U.S. or what may potentially happen in the U.S. with regards to regulation, could you tell us what is Strides Pharma, which is the B2C business, and the API business, which will be separately listed? What is the exposure to the U.S. market to begin with?
So I think combinedly, we should probably have a exposure of a little over $100 million. So it's not a very big size for us compared to the total scale of the company. But having said that, we do have a very strong momentum of growth. We are only a three-year-old company in the U.S., so we already have an important sales size there. And it continues to be a very profitable and increasingly important market for Strides. So to say that there would be no overhang of what are potential challenges from the regulatory landscape, not regulatory, more from the policy landscape, it'll be dumbfounded. So I think that we should, we are conscious about potential challenges, but we really do not know at this stage what they are. It's too early days, and there are contrarian opinions coming about policy shifts. I just think that if cost of goods is a key concern for the current administration, then Indian generics will continue to play an important role in the U.S. health system.
And what about a border tax? What is the likelihood or the probability, and how much do you think it would impact your sales by?
I think, considering that about 30-odd% of the volumes, come from Indian generics, if there's a border tax, it's going to have an impact on cost of goods to consumers. So I'm not sure if that's going to be anything material, if at all. At this time, we don't even know what is being spoken about. So I just think that will be counterproductive to have a border tax and then increase cost of generics. I don't think the U.S. industry can support any volume that would potentially will exist, assuming there's a border tax. So I'm quite confident that things will stay status quo. I think there's a lot of noise now. I think we should give some time before we all start getting worrying or feeling good about this market.
All right, Arun, we have to leave it on that note. Thank you very much for joining in and speaking with us. Those are the Hexaware now.